Complaining is like bad breath. You only notice it when it comes out of someone else's mouth. Reverend Will Bowen said that. Hilarious. Hilarious but true. We complain because the world is not how we like it. And there is so much to complain about. And sometimes it's like a competition. You think your life is bad? Here's my list. Like Mammy in Gone with the Wind, I told you and told you, complaining just keeps sucking you down into the well of negativity and does you no favors. So, how many times did you complain today? And what was your biggest complaint? Hi, I'm Sheila and this is Lumia 24. Light on! So, what exactly do I mean by complaining? Let's take the weather. If you ask me how's the weather, I can say it in two ways. I can say, it's hot outside, like I'm simply reporting the weather. But I can also say, it's hot outside, like I'm dying in the middle of the desert and my skin is burning off. That's complaining. Complaining is taking an observation and adding negative energy or emotion to it. When you complain, you are indeed suffering. But here's the thing, when you go through life, struggle is inevitable, but suffering is a choice. Complaining is a trap that sabotages your happiness and success at work because it triggers your negativity bias. Glad you asked. Negativity bias is your brain's natural impulse to focus on anything that is bad, wrong, or threatening. You see, the brain has this great job of keeping us safe and protected. And the negativity bias keeps us alert and focused on the bad things or threats to our survival. And because your brain cannot differentiate between reality, imagination, important or insignificant, once this button is triggered, our attention goes to all the bad stuff, which makes it really hard to see things in any other light. And without being aware or making a conscious effort to override our instinctive negative tendencies, we keep ourselves from seeing what's good around us. I know complaining can feel so good, especially when others jump in. But the sense of relief is not from the communal complaining. The fact is, we feel that we are finally being heard. We are validated. It means we are not alone. Complaining is completely unproductive, but we are so busy spilling out our woes to friends, colleagues, loved ones, the house help, the cab driver, or anyone who will listen, that potential solutions, positive improvements, these are far, far, far away from our mind. In fact, in Will Bowen's book, A Complaint-Free World, he gives an acronym to explain the five reasons why we complain. Gripe, as in complain, got it? And he says that there are five reasons why we complain. The G is for get attention. Most people complain to get attention. They want to feel heard and validated. It's just a cry, hey, notice me. So if you see that someone is complaining to get attention, just turn, look at them and ask, what's going on really well with your job right now? Or what's really going well with your kids? One of the two things will happen. They will either look at you like you're crazy, haven't I just been telling you what crap I'm going through, and walk away, or they will tell you what's going on well. You would have shifted their focus. And your focus. Complaining is contagious. You don't want to catch it. Win-win for both. The R in gripe stands for remove responsibility. Here they're complaining to tell you that the world is against them and it's really not possible for them to do anything. Kinda like, why didn't you submit your schoolwork? What can I do? The dog ate it. I chased it. It was torn by the time I got it. It's not possible. It's not my fault. That's the running theme. So here you ask, if it were possible, how would you do it? Stops complaining in its track every time. I is for inspire, envy or brag. When you complain about another person, whether it's your spouse or your coworker or your friend, you are saying, I'm not like that. I'm so much better. That is why gossip is also complaining. Though it's tempting to give in to gossip and join the thrashing, you are now a wiser, better person. So here's how you stop it. Let's say he tells you, My boss is always late to work and makes me work overtime. You say, I love the fact that you're always on time. If she tells you, she's always so grumpy and unfriendly, you say, I love the fact that you are so pleasant. And see how this one works. It's like pouring water over fire. You just put out the bout of complaints. The P is for power. Here the person wants you on their side while they complain about someone else or something. They are bringing to you nuggets of information because they think it's really important. Most of the time, people never take up issues directly with whoever they have a grouse with. We have an issue with our spouse, we complain to our friend. We have an issue with our boss, we complain to our spouse. And then we wonder why the situation never seems to improve. Parents face this a lot when they're called in to referee the sibling fights. So the next time you think you're being pulled into a place where you have no role, just be polite and say, I think you need to take it up directly with that person. Step out. Yeah, I know, sometimes we also feel very important about being handed this piece of information. Don't give in to temptation. Step away. Great reminder for you too. When the urge to complain strikes, talk to the person responsible. Have that uncomfortable conversation or forever hold your peace. The E is for excuse poor performance. And this is the last piece. People will give every rational excuse about why something didn't work out. You know, I didn't get this promotion because she's the boss's favorite anyway. Your children will use this a lot too. I got poor grades because I was called out of class to tweak the school's website, or my teacher graded it very strictly. Don't get caught. Ask them, how do you plan to improve next time? So that's how you deal with people who are complaining to you. And when you complain too, notice which of the five reasons apply here. As they say, charity begins at home. And oh, by the way, it's also complaining if you just do it in your head. It is complaining if the issue is not taken up with the person or situation that you have a grouse with. Write in to me, leave your comments and tell me, how has the complaining affected you? What are you doing to break this pattern? Complaining is an epidemic, and if you have complainers in your circle, share this video with them too. Spread the light, folks. Let's create a complaint-free world.